Dear friends, good evening. We are gathered here tonight to explore together, to meditate in this amazing symphony that it is very hard to get during a concert performance, because you need to live in real time what we live in the times of the rehearsals. So now we will try to explore the first movement of the symphony with our beautiful orchestra. And then when you will listen to the concert, this will make more sense what we're trying to achieve. Actually, in fact, the first movement is very difficult material. There were some critics when Shostakovich first composed this symphony saying, oh, that actually the theme and the material is to make a symphony of 25 minutes. And this is a symphony of 67 minutes. But in fact, Shostakovich was the one that insisting that the most important thing is not what it is, the theme or the material itself. It's how you perceive that and how you are developing that. So it's a little bit like Beethoven. You know, Beethoven, to make the Fifth Symphony, the very famous beginning, was trying to rewrite and rewrite until it will find the bone of the theme, to find the basement of the theme, to build this great cathedral. Here, the great cathedral, it is the soul of the mankind. It is this relationship of the human being with the people. And questions what is victory and what is defeat. And maybe my defeat, it is my victory. And maybe my life, it is one defeat after the next defeat. And that's my victory. And my wounds, it is my jewelry. And this is all this first theme that I'm gonna, the introduction I'm gonna present you now. It is actually, and I want this to say to the orchestra, everybody tries to play it beautiful. But what is beauty in Goya, as an example? We see the Caprichos or something like this. Is that beautiful? Well, no, but then yes. It's not beautiful what we see, but it's beautiful that we are able to feel that and we are able to be a better person after that. So this is a symphony that makes a big jump to the aquarium of, in the DNA of our spirit, when we see darkness and then achieve a future with a life, with light and with hope, that this is the last movement of the pastoral. So I start with the first movement, and we see how we go. This is the introduction. Somebody can find similarities with the Fifth Symphony of Shostakovich. Nobody can say that it's something beautiful, this. And we shouldn't make it beautiful. We should keep it a little bit ugly, as ugly as the basement of a house. When we build something, the basement has to be really solid, without any hope, without any sensitivity, without any tragedy. To build a tragedy, we need a solid basement for that. For that, I suggest to start with a very, every note should be like a sforzato from the bottom of our being, and not to vibrate from the very beginning. Vibrate when you want to extend the sound. Also, in the fifth bar, it is very important not to reduce the volume, not to play the two bars with full volume, and then when we go to eighth notes, this we need to keep the volume. Also, I need collaboration, the second violins and the viola. The second violins are always moving forward, the violas are a little bit static. The violas could go a little. One more time, please. Give a more sforzato in the beginning. This, the extension of the bow when you down and up, don't release the sound. It's like insisting to the sound. No mercy in these few bars. Here I need mercy. Here I need mercy in the diminuendo.
Merci.
Mercy. Mercy. That's very important. After this, look what happened to me. I will tell you about my own story. And then starts this incredible place. I still need more collaboration. Now you were too fast, the violas. Please, bar six, the eighth note that we have in bar six, don't make diminuendos, the violas. It's crescendo till the rest, and then we continue with fortissimo. Everybody, when they see diminuendo, they start softer. Diminuendo is only the starts with fortissimo, and then it is the diminuendo, not softer, not più piano. It's a bad thing with the microphones, because in this symphony, I'm going to break everything. So I need from every person that plays in this orchestra a maximum in the beginning. Pressure. Thank you. Now, what I would like to ask everybody is when we're going to make this transition and dive to the bottom, to this aquarium of our being, what I'm saying, to the most incredible grief in this eternal loneliness, in this universal emptiness. For me, it is very important to go in a slow tempo. You know, usually what they were doing in the old times, when they were finishing this big introduction, they were taking faster tempo to give direction to this. In fact, I'm doing this also, but I'm doing in a smart way that will not be noticeable that I give direction. What it is important, it's that the eighth note of this theme, pam, pam, from the beginning has the same velocity. And when you go down bow in the second bar of that, don't make a new start. It is più piano and then it's pianissimo. Then for me it is important that the first violins is like you play fortissimo, but in another world. The activity of the rhythm has to be fortissimo. The sound can be even more illuminated to kind of cold espressivo, windy. It's like the old houses of St. Petersburg that the windows are broken and you can listen to the wind inside. And it's very cold and unbearable. This is what we need to do. I would like to ask you to start before Cipher 1, 2 bars, and make this transition. The eighth note will have a character if you will measure how you release the sound in the first beat. Not pa, pam, pam. See, that's the difference. Look at me. It's like this eighth note is like, say, yeah, 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 yeah. It's all to say yes, 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 yes. Three. Viola a little more. Give a color, or as you release the sound, give a little more color. Look at me. And yeah, yeah, look each other to play together the eighth note, to be absolutely together. Now softer. But yes, without a new start. With confidence. Tom, wom, wom. It's not a new start, it's the continuation, it's the echo of the previous bar. The viola doesn't release the sound, that's why we don't have this. They do that, you don't do. Too early the viola. Too early the viola one more time. Sorry for that. I am here to say the truth, right? Pianissimo. Continue. And from far away. You see, it is good now. It is very good. I want to give a little more color and a little vibrato in the top notes when you go in the A string. And the 16 notes, the punctir, I ask you something very difficult, to have this color that you have, but to have a kind of marcato punctir. Ram babi, no. Da da da, ram. That's. You have to do it with a rhythm. There's nothing you have to do here. It's, it's two movements. It's not da da da. It's ram babi. Same thing, without gaps. This is not good. I listen the tarari roi. And the tarari ra. This I don't have to hear. It's so difficult in any magic. You want it to make easy? I cannot make it easy as I do it. I will demonstrate. You play the same thing. So I will show you the difference why we struggle for. Look. No problem. But that's not what the composer wants. Now let's go to the difficult version. Here, in that place starts the big sequence. I need you a little bit to come out from this pianist. We're straight in second cipher. And one. I want you a little bit earlier to leave the note. This. And one. Connect. This has to be connected. Tarari, connect. The point is that when we play first time, it was quite impressive, but we are going to the fortissimo much before the third letter. The fortissimo, it is only two after three, one and a half after three. So we need to increase the dynamic and go and go and go. It's like Icarus, you know, he wants to go to the sun and he's burning, but he's going. You need this resistance to be burned a little bit when you go up. You go too easy to the big sound. I want to go with with resistance. When they make tarim, also in the auftakt, give me a second cipher, and one. The first beat has to be softer. As they're doing, you have to do the same. No, ta da, I start. Ta da. And one. It's not together, the viola. Ta da, it's not together, and I can hear that. Maybe the audience is not hearing that, but I hear. We need to be together. And one. You make a gap, ta-da-di, ta-da-ma, ta-da-di, yeah. No gaps. I get warm. One more time. It's very important for me. If this would not work, doesn't work the symphony. Good, good. It is a little bit scary when we have fortissimo and we have this cold sunshine. You know, when it is sunny, it is cold, like this morning, like yesterday morning. It is sunny and it is cold. It is very important to keep the tempo, not to accelerate the tempo, to sustain in the tempo and fulfill the tempo. Okay, in three, can we make one more in three? Don't rush. Three. And faster. This is the first hope that I see in D major. C minor and D major. This is first, I need that you will go from zero immediately the crescendo to come out, like a rainbow here. Can we do this straight from four, C for four? And you want keep dark. Here, it is something also very important. Here starts a diminuendo that we want to play in that place, and we need to resist and start poco a poco a poco to do the diminuendo. Now we didn't do any diminuendo, to be honest, because we changed also the bow, so we need to be attentive of this diminuendo. This ta-ra-ra, can you have only the cello in this ta-ra-ra, and one. Little more diminuendo. It's like morning. And one. Again. Now with a, it is a cipher five with a, all the orchestra. Five. Now sequence. Thank you. Good. Very good. Very good. I just want to say that there is this, let's say, ugly transition when the bassoon's playing the... it is after four. What I would like to the, all the winds, all these half notes that you have with the syncopations and etc., not to release, not to make a new start when you change note, just to have one line of pressure. And then in seven, in cipher seven, you have tenuto, it's Shostakovich, right, tenuto. So, pa-bam, 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 not pa-bam, pa-bam, pa-bam. It is tenuto. It is just pull the sound to the very, to its end. Can we please have from four? It's better to have one after, sorry, it is six. One after six with the auftakt. It's nice. We can hear all the nuances that there are written. I mean, crescendo diminuendo should not be exaggerating. We need to stay in this mood, in this ascetic mood. You know what it is the problem? When people they try to make it beautiful, they see a crescendo, the music is not so beautiful, let's make the crescendo to make it beautiful, to give some suspense in the music. We don't need that. This music has to be played like everyone has to leave the hall. In that. You need to insist in this meditation, in this depth of consideration. It's a statement, it's not an aesthetic theory about let's make it beautiful. So all the nuances has to be more reduced, it's just a direction, it gives a direction. More reaction to the last tense doing the music, the first tense, make the with a short pinello, the they draw. Pam 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 pam. What? Imagine a chorus that is doing that with a breath, sul fiato. No, pam 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 pam. Can we try just the accompagnamento? Three. gently a little softer. More resonance. Nice. That's nice. So 8, please, all together. Less crescendo the first tense. We lose the blending. You feel that? We are losing the blending. All this crescendo has to be careful not to lose the organism, not to. I shouldn't notice that somebody is doing the crescendo. The group has to breathe. And in general, the dynamic has to be reduced. It has to be a little smoother and more airy, more flautando, with the same constant vibrato. One last time, this. Only the accompaniamento, crescendo. With air only, with air. Keep the air. No accents. many beautiful things. You did amazing things. As an example, in 10. 10 was super magic, what you did. Bravi, bravi. And also I like the violas, the way you go to the crescendo. Just want to ask you one thing. In 11, in the fourth bar, 1, 2, 3, 4, in the fifth bar, already the first violin should go a little louder in the fifth bar. And violas and celli, when you start in the fourth bar of 11, when you start this, showing the secundas, these dissonances, don't go too loud, too early. Keep a little, because I stop listening the first violin, so now I'm losing the balance. So first violin is more. Always try to, what I'm asking you all the time, don't listen to yourself, listen to the group. Here I want you to listen to yourself a little bit, to insist your line, okay? The other thing I would like to ask you, and also to our friends, to show what is the difference, how different can be a line. Can you please play with ordinary, in an ordinary way, 13 cello and basses, just an ordinary way. Forget what I told you. Forget what I told you. Okay, just to see how different can be a result. And now, with sul tasto, it's only air, only the ghosts singing this, not people. If it's possible, the with sul tasto, with air, more crescendo, all the voices except the first voice. Take more initiative to the crescendo, but don't go to the real sound. Even softer. Just listen, this is the first chord. Only air has to be, like, not instrument, but air. Bass is a little more. Yes. That's the color that wants the composer. Basses? Basses only. Diminuendo, everybody. Diminuendo, boom, continue. And only air. Peace. So it is a kind of, it's a magic moment that also makes this transition with this. Now I would like to go back and one before 11 to make all this transition with violins. It's a little bit exercise. connect. Connect. Les first divisi, les first divisi, the others. Together the diminuendo. And in the air. Legato. This is the most dramatic moment in the, when we stop. I would like to have diminuendo. In that place. When you start the crescendo, dear friends, when we have crescendo, I need the initiative of the last tense. The last tense should make the crescendo. Don't take the initiative because we will not be blended. Wait for them. Good. Very good. I would like to make a little jump now to play this theme. Ta-da-da-da-da-dee-da-dum, ta-da-da-da-da-dee-da-dum. I would like to listen to the woodwinds, how they play this theme in bar 188. One, three. And I want you to show me ti ra 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 ri ra 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 ri ti ra 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 ri ri ra ri ra ri ra ri ra 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 ri ra ra ri ra ri. Is this the same theme becomes this crazy cry in this place? Three phrasing. This ta di da di da di da di no ta da 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 ta di da di da di da di da 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 di 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 di. Give a weight to this theme. 3, 4, 8. We have that. Great. The strings, the same thing. Cipher 23. And ta 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 ti, ta 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 ti. Long note. Ta 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 ti. Don't release. One more time. 3, four, one. So that's why I wanted to play so tender this theme to play the first time, and this becomes that. That's very important. If we don't have a concrete character to every transformation of this theme, then we lose the navigator in the symphony. We go back. That was a little example how we have to look to the form. We go in 16 now. I want you to say in 140, in this bar, that 141, in the second beat with the diminuendo, my heart is broken. My heart is broken. This is ta-da-di-ra-da. I cannot go on. I cannot continue. And when we do the crescendo, don't go to marcato. Keep the air. We become a little marcato in the crescendo. Okay, one last time. Now we had the nice crescendo because they did the crescendo and you went them. Three and softer the violas, flautando more. You know, you see, I would like to have from the violas a sound of alto flute, an orchestra from alto flutes. It sounds a little portato. In the rest, we have still the resonance of the line. So to have fragments. Straight from the development of 17. Connect.
Good winds, go. Good winds.
You cannot go with the crescendo if they will not do the crescendo. I know you want to play, you have beautiful sound, but I need to wait from them. I ask you, go, attention. We need more tension in that. And then you need to blend this tension. We need to work like a body, like an organism. If you have, okay, you have crescendo, the dynamic, but if you hear that, they don't go to that. Yes. One more time, please, from 17. You can start softer, the flute, and you can start make softer. When the cello coming soft and we wait for their crescendo, the tension. And one beat. Straight, please, 18. 18, please. You get what was wrong, okay? I don't need to say. 18. And one.
Wait, street. Now you can give.
Thank you.
here, you see how is the development in this to the edge of the spirit of mankind goes. From this small exposition goes to that. Shostakovich. Now, what it is my intention? I want to hear in Cipher 24, you remember this pam 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 pam. This accompaniamento in a slow tempo it is pam 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 pam. I need to listen that from the brass and the timpani. Can we have this from in 24? I would make it a little shorter. Pum 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 pum. 1, 2. First trombone make a pum pum pum. More gaps. 3 and. The crescendo earlier, immediately crescendo when you after the piano, okay? 1 and 2, and I say. That's it. Now I would like to that we will go a little back. Tam ta dam. You mean 170? Ta dam. Retake. It's possible that you will first, second violins in an interesting place. Can you play, please, 178? 178? 178? And in this fortissimo, to give me the feeling that everybody from the audience understand that it's not a double strich, but it is. That is a variation of this theme. It is a development of this theme. It's possible. I'm talking about bar 178. I want, because we have 3F, I'm losing the phrasing. I need a little bit more phrasing in that. That everybody would understand from where comes this theme. Can you give me this from the second beat, first, second violins? Yes, but with phrasing. And one, and. Please, now I would like to listen to the group. That's also a very important thing, to build the big lushy sound of the string group. For that, we take treatments and we change bows for create all these big sounds so the brass could play in the dynamic that is written. Otherwise, usually in the orchestras, they reduce the brass when it is forte, fortissimo, so we can hear the hiss. But we take special treatments now to do that. Please, all the strings, play from 20. 20. Cipher 20. We and. I need a little bit more bow in the 16. Tam, ti-ding, no tam. Ta-tum, a-tum, Ding, little more bow, like this in the 16th note. Okay? One more time. You write it after. Three. And
Sound. Longer 16. Tam, ta-dam, tam, ta-dam.
Pesante and longer 16. No, tam, ta-dam. And it's a little stretch the 16, so we have more power in that. From please, 20, 1, 2, 3, 4 after 20. Let's play with sound. Ladies and gentlemen, let's play with sound. Three, and that's with sound. That is with sound. Now all together, to see if we cut in the orchestra. 20, all together. Not too pesante, because the last time was too pesante. I like it pesante, but not extreme pesante. Okay, three and. Thank you. Just, I want to show something to the audience. Can you go back? In Ziffer 1, the first violins. Ziffer 1. Let's listen. This is very important for me, Kostya. This is super important for me to see how we build the symphony and to keep this in mind from where we start and where we go. To build the navigator in our mind and our hearts. One, listen to the first violins. And now we go back. This is very fast in Allegro that we stopped. It is 2:32 with the Auftakt. Pam, 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 pim, pam, pam. It's the same theme that becomes sarcastic. So I want you for you. Pam, 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 pim, pam, pam, pim, pam, pam, ta, ta, ti, ta, ta, ya, ta, ta, ta. Ta-da-dum. Sarcastic. Okay? Can we have with the viola, the cello, and the bass should be pop, 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 pop. The up bow is very important. Staccatissimo, as we play in the third movement, because the timpani plays on the main beat, so we lose the second beat, okay? From Allegro. One, two, three. Here, I want from the trombones and the timpani celli basses in 32 to be more secco. Ta-pam, pam, in the offbeat. Can we have only timpani, celli, basses, and trombones? And no, without the trumpets. One, two, one. 32, Ziffer 32. Yeah? Okay. One, two, wait. Great, great. Like this. All together, 32. All the crescendi, maximum motivation to the woodwinds. Pim, pim, pam, pia. This crescendo. Okay? Maximum crescendo. Everybody has to make the crescendo that is written. One, two, possible that everybody gets crazy with this crescendo in the end. Con tutta forza. I need that your bow will have only three hair after this crescendo. No, no diminuendo, no rallentando. And more marcato. One more time the same thing. The world is dancing in their own graves, you know, it is... One, two, eight.
Thank you.
There is no piano. No piano. There is not forte piano. It is only forte, right? Yeah. After it is the forte piano. One, two, three, four. Here, stop, 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 stop. All the wind instruments, like this. All the clarinets, bells up. The Valkyries are coming. Should be shock here. And you have to be in the kind of adrenaline that you don't notice the fortissimo anymore. You don't need to put the earrings. Let's play. Three, eight. That is the, for that. So this pianissimo sultasso we have in the beginning becomes that. For me, what it is very important, the strings, when you have this crescendo in the tremolo, while it is we have the tutti, 3F that you have, right? Play 3F, make diminuendo in 1F while it is fortissimo there, and when I take off, you have a crescendo. Because you are in the limit, and then we don't have a lot of crescendo. Okay? Can we take from bar 294, please? 294. And I think good attacca with a 294 we found. And I. From the good days, from the good days. Now risk, pianissimo. Pianissimo, risk now. Good. No. You have the theme, but it is a little bit too loud. Only starts the crescendo there. You see, this is what I mean. And too many accidents, so I had to stop. Let's take from Bravo. Thirty-nine second bar. Now I wait, the bass is super pianissimo. Thank you. Can we take? I need the 32 notes to be exactly 32, not to extend, as the beginning. Okay, can we take from 43, please? Third beat. Wait to the third beat. Okay, one more time. That was better. If I know that it's super difficult, but I want you to risk. Risk. How I say, no risky, no whiskey. We need to risk. One more time. Now I see you. Sordino, Sordino. Can we do the coda? 44? And very soft. I really hope now that after this rehearsal, you will listen with a little bit different ears the performance. And thank you for your patience. Thank you very much.